Today I will introduce you to a good book with lots of clear images, engaging content, and it is important to help you cure yourself and the people around you with natural herbs around you. That Lost Book of Remedies. The Lost Book of Remedies is helping Americans achieve curative self-sufficiency even in the darkest times by saving the lost remedies of our grandparents. Own this book. You'll find several pictures that will help you identify it. You'll also discover the little things you need to look for in order to be 100% sure you've got the right plant and not a look-alike. This part goes extremely in-depth so that people with no plant knowledge can use it to its full potential. Do you know what happens when you pour salt onto a cabbage and cover it with water?
In a few days, it starts to ferment, bringing to life wonderful microbes that offer some of the best protection possible for your digestive tract while regulating your bowel movements and preventing both diarrhea and constipation for a mere 27 calories per cup. This probiotic offers 4 grams of fiber, 35% of your daily vitamin C needs, 21% of your daily vitamin K needs, and 12% of your daily iron needs. How's that for a nutritional powerhouse?
I'm sure you recognize this common driveway weed. What you probably don't know is that it's a powerful anti-inflammatory that helps wounds heal a lot faster, and how to make a poultice out of its leaves and use it to dress your wounds or cuts, or if you or one of your friends is suffering from an autoimmune disease like arthritis. You can use this as a remedy immediately.
Pretty sure you would recognize a marshmallow, but maybe you wouldn't recognize the marshmallow plant growing in your backyard. Marshmallow plant with flowers. You will be surprised with powerful antiviral properties hidden in its roots, so whenever you have an infection caused by a virus like flu, herpes, or hepatitis A, B, or C, this remedy will slow down the virus's ability to reproduce and allow your body to fight back. Would you like to explore the method to create this special recipe?
Order the book and read it today. Link below description. You know this tree and you know where to find it or have seen it before. Another weed you'll find in your backyard is known as Seneca. The name comes from the Seneca natives. Used to make a poultice from it to cure deadly snake bites during the 18th century. A Scottish doctor observed that symptoms of rattlesnake bite resembled the advanced stages of pneumonia and lung disease. So he tried it out, and it was so effective that soon the plant was exported to Europe, where it continued to save many lives. And you will know how to turn it into an expectorant that cleared the lungs of his patients and expelled any mucus. If you ever have any kind of lung problems from the flu or a nagging cough that just won't go away, all you see is in the chapter, Weeds Backyard. In this huge chapter, you'll find all the other medicinal weeds and backyard plants that are hidden around your property. You've got a homegrown pharmacy that you don't even know about. Most of these plants are edible and can provide you with precious nutrients if you ever run low on food. This goes for all the plants you'll find in the Lost Book of Remedies. Not only will you learn what parts of the plants are edible and how to prepare them,
not only that, but you also discover how to identify witches and wild remedies growing in the forest. If you get lost in the forest, will you know which of these plants are edible, which one is a remedy for hypertension, and which ones are poisonous?
Have you seen this tree yet? It grows in most forest glades. You'll discover how to use it to effectively treat not only common colds but lung infections as well. Breathing in the steam from leaves that have been boiled in water will also calm any asthma attack. This is why 100 years ago people with asthma didn't die from it. If you have this trouble, don't worry, eat it. Native Americans used it as a sweetener 200 years ago, and it tastes better than all the greens. What people don't know is that this plant is a strong diuretic that you can also take for poor blood circulation.
Much more, you'll discover how to identify the wild edibles and remedies that grow especially in the prairie like boneset, which can be easily turned into one of the most powerful antipyretics.
This means that it drastically reduces the fever. In fact, the name boneset was derived from the plant's use in the treatment of breakbone fever. Here is another widespread weed. If you ever get an infected wound or cut, you will have a modern bandage that heals wounds faster and better than, and also show you the strange reason why putting a leaf of this plant in your shoes in the morning is as good as a cold shower and a cup of coffee you have never tried and done it. Right? Order the book and read it today. Link below description. Are you there? Keep researching. A similar weed called woolly lamb's ear can be added to the frontier poultice to stop the bleeding in a matter of seconds. This plant is high in vitamin K, the vitamin that coagulates the blood. It is the powdered vitamin that was given to soldiers in World War II to pour over their wounds if they were shot, and if you or a loved one has diabetes or problems with coagulation or wound healing. Make sure you have this healing cataplasm around your home without delay, oh yeah? No matter where you live in America, there's a source of water nearby. And when there's water, there are cattails. You probably already know cattails are edible, but I doubt you know how tasty they are. I'll show you how I cook them in the field and at home and how to turn them into flour, but probably the most important and least known thing about cattails is the jelly-like substance that grows between its leaves. This gel is also one of the best cures for nail and foot fungus. On a different note, this gel is the only part of the cattail that is widely considered to not be edible. It's not poisonous, so why isn't it edible? Well, because it has a powerful numbing effect on moist tissues. It has even been used as a Novocaine substitute. Yes, it's an anesthetic that you can use in many, many situations. When the pioneers were hit with a ravaging toothache, they would just go get their jar of cattail ooze and rub it around their gums. The pain would subside in minutes. There are still many. The Lost Book of Remedies comprises all the medicinal and edible trees in North America. Let's explore it. One of the things you'll find here is the ultimate survival tree that grows on almost every street in the U.S. I call it that because you can use the sap as medicine, its flowers as sleeping pills, its leaves as food, and the inner bark as cordage. Do you recognize this tree? The Native Americans would cook its honey sweet pods and eat them, according to a recent medical study at Michigan State University. The flowers of this tree strongly prevent the spreading growth of prostate, breast, colon, and lung tumors. You'll find all of these things in the Lost Book of Remedies. Today is your chance to play a role in doing that by putting the Lost Book of Remedies where it belongs, on your bookshelf or in your medicine cabinet. Finally, in the last chapter of the Lost Book of Remedies, you'll find the once common treatments our grandparents used whenever they were ill, like the spice you add to your meals that can stop bleeding in just a matter of seconds. You'll also discover the one substance you probably overlooked and should add to your medicinal kit or stockpile. This detoxifying agent kills parasites and viruses in the digestive tract, or the common household stain buster that can clear away most fungus and bacterial skin infections. But you can also use it to disinfect huge quantities of water, even a well. It's much better than bleach, which leaves an odor for weeks. This book has accumulated everything for a long time to come to you today. The Lost Book of Remedies is over 300 pages of our forefathers' most powerful natural cures that have been lost to history. When medicines will vanish, you'll need this on your bookshelf. Why you should put garlic in your ear before going to sleep. What happens when you pour salt into a cabbage? The most powerful natural painkiller you can make at home. What powerful healing plants you're growing around your house. Best part about this forgotten onion remedy: the physical book has 300 pages, with three colored pictures for every plant and for every medicine. All are packed in a book. In addition, if you get the Lost Book of Remedies today, you'll also be able to take advantage of two exclusive gifts that will be off the table soon. What are you waiting for? Order and turn it into a guide today. Visit the link below to find out more and order.